Good afternoon, students. Yesterday we discussed about the SN2 reaction, bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. Let's a quick review of SN2 reaction. The SN2 reaction is a second order reaction. According to kinetics of SN2 reaction, the rate of reaction depends on the concentration of haloalkane as well as alkyl. Hence, it is a rate law. It is the suggested mechanism of SN2 reaction. This is a reactant substrate molecule and the attack of nucleophile from the backside of the reactant. This is the formation of transition state and the formation of desired product. This is a view of SN2 reaction, backside attack of nucleophile and the it is a leaving group. Bimolecular nuclear reaction is concerted reactions, means these are the one step reaction. This is also discussed yesterday. This is the energy profile diagram of the SN2 reaction. Now, today we are focusing on SN1 reaction, which is called unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. The SN1 reaction is a nucleophilic substitution reaction where the rate determining step is unimolecular. It is a type of organic substitution reaction. SN1 stands for substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. Thus, the rate equation, which states that the SN1 reaction is dependent on the electrophile but not on the nucleophile, holds in situations where the amount of nucleophile is far greater than the amount of the carbocation intermediate. This is the example of SN1 reaction. This is tertiary butyl bromide react with water. Water here acts as a nucleophile. It is a product, tertiary butyl alcohol, and it is a leaving group, HBr. What the kinetics say? The kinetics of SN1 reaction. If we were to double the concentration of haloalkane, we can see that the rate of the reaction will proceed twice as fast as the initial rate. But if we were to double the concentration of nucleophile, here water, there was no change observed in the rate of reaction. Hence, the rate law is given. Rate is equal to K dependent on the first order of the tertiary butyl bromide, keeping the concentration of alkyl constant. But rate is independent on the concentration of nucleophile, keeping the concentration of tertiary butyl bromide is constant. So, overall rate law is K and the concentration of tertiary butyl bromide. So, it is a first order reaction. It is the suggested mechanism of SN1 reaction on the basis of rate law. It is a double step reaction. In step number 1, there is a formation of important intermediate which is called carbocation. Remember that in SN2 reaction, carbocation does not form while transition state is formed. And in step number 2, the carbocation reacts with nucleophile and the formation of substituted product. It is the energy profile diagram of SN1 reaction. It is the reactant molecule. This is nucleophile. This is the breaking of this bond, CBr bond, the formation of carbocation, and then the formation of this bond with nucleophile, and finally the formation of substituted product. Now, what stereochemistry says? The racemization is an important feature of SN1 reaction. The carbocation intermediate is formed in the reaction rate determining step is an sp2 hybridized carbon with a trigonal planar geometry. This allows two different ways for the nucleophile attack, one on either side of planar molecule. If neither way is preferentially favored, these two ways occur equally, yielding a racemic mixture of enantiomer. You know that about the racemic mixture? Racemic mixture, when equimolar amount of enantiomers are mixed, then optically inactive mixture is formed, which is called racemic mixture, and the process is called racemization. This is illustrated in the SN1 reaction of S. S is a configuration of molecule 3-chloro-3-methylhexane with an iodide ion, which yields a racemic mixture of 3-iodo-3-methylhexane. Here is the example. This is the reactant molecule, which is S enantiomer. In rate determining step, a carbocation is formed. Since carbocation is a sp2 hybridized planar geometry, planar carbocation is formed in rate determining step here. Hence, the possibility of attack of nucleophile is from the both sides. This is a nucleophile iodide ion, which may be attacked on the front side as well as the back side of the molecule. As a result, both enantiomers are produced in equal amount, that is racemization. Here iodide attack, also here iodide attack. So there is a possibility of formation of R enantiomer as well as S enantiomers in equal amount, that is racemization takes place. SN2 reaction. Inversion is the important feature of SN2 reaction. Inversion stands for inversion in conformation. In an SN2 reaction, the stereochemistry of product is inverted compared to that of the substrate. An SN2 reaction is a backside attack. Here we can see it is a leaving of this nucleophile and the attack of this incoming nucleophile. Both are synchronized takes place. This is from the removal of front side, attack from the backside. An SN2 reaction is a backside attack. The nucleophile attacks the electrophilic center. This is the electrophilic carbon center on the side that is opposite to the leaving group. This is the leaving group and this is the attacking nucleophile. During a backside attack, the stereochemistry at the carbon atom changes. There is inversion of conformation. This is the transition state. Now removal of that side and attachment of that side means the configuration should be reversed, starting from S2-bromobutane while the product is S2-butanol. You can also see by this 3D diagram the removal of leaving group and the attack of this nucleophile.